Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm gonna teach you on how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So as you can see here, there's a native house, a bridge, and other things that you can see typically in a landscape painting. And I'll recommend this for the beginners also because it will be very challenging for them. And please don't forget to subscribe, if you haven't subscribed yet, and hit that bell button if you want to receive some future notification of my new videos and tutorials. Okay everyone, so you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see there the 5 limited colors, the brushes, and other things that we're gonna need to paint this tutorial. Okay, so I'm going to start now and I'm not gonna waste my time. And first, we're gonna do the sketching. It is the first step. Sketching first before we're gonna try to paint and try to do the underpainting. So I have here the raw umber and white. So I'm mixing white to the raw umber to become lighter and it will be easy for me to blend. Yep, I have water. Yeah, it's a lot of water. Okay. So here I am going to paint the house. It will be the native house. Usually you can see this in the Philippines. Can do that. You can create first from triangles. I'm going to put something here. It will be a little complicated house, but it will still be simple house. It will be a little in the mountain. There. I'm gonna put the door here, yeah, and then I can put the rice field and some, yeah, I'm gonna put the river or a stream here, just a small stream, and then here I'll put this part here will be coconut trees, so this will be coconut tree forest, and the light coming from here, and this will be a river, just a small river. Yeah. And then I'll put a tree here, yeah, something. Okay, and then on the background I'm gonna put a wheat over here, some a little forest, and then I'm gonna put a mountain here. Okay. Okay, this is it. So I'm going to, I think I'm done with the sketching and I'm going to start painting now. Okay. So I will be, I think I'm going to paint in the afternoon. I'm gonna make it a little pinkish or purple skies. Okay. And then I'm gonna use some blue and red and white to make it a little lighter purples. There.
Yeah. We have to blend it well, yeah. And then I'm going to use this blue and red. We're gonna create a mountain. This will be a forest mountain, just very near to us. Here I'm gonna put some amber bluish and red and blue. There. So it'll be a little purple. I want white, more white, and then. To make it a little smooth. There. Okay, and then here I'm gonna make it dark. And blue. So I'll just mix the red and blue to make it dark purple. This will be the underpainting or the background of the trees or. But I'm gonna use a more bluish to create some forest here. It will be a distant forest, but it should be lighter, everyone. So remember that. There. Okay. And this one here, it will be a big tree, but I'm going to make it darker first, so raw umber and blue. I'm gonna make it a little dark here. Okay, so I think I'm going to put more backgrounds. I'll be using this yellow with a little bluish, yeah, and also some red. to make some orange. There. So we're gonna do first, we're going to fill this everything with the underpainting. Okay, and then we're gonna use this lighter yellow to create distant fields there. Don't worry everyone, this is just the underpainting. Okay, now I'll also fill the I'm going to also fill this one with background color first, light blue color here. Okay. So I'm gonna use this blue color, raw umber, and then I'm gonna add some white, a little light brown. I saw some. So we're gonna do an underpainting first here. It will be a light brown. And then I'm gonna create a lighter brown. There. And then also here. So we're gonna do first the underpainting. Everything will be under painting first. Before we're gonna create the details. And then this one will be dark again. Okay. There. I'll just create a darker. Shades here. Okay, open your brush and then some. Okay, so I think I am done with the underpainting or the first coats of background colors. So I think I'm gonna start now. I'm gonna start adding some clouds. I think I'm gonna do the clouds first. It's too dark. I'm gonna add some white. It will be cumulus clouds. I'm gonna put also some pinks, red and white. So I'm going to use this yellow and red. Sorry everyone if very noisy outside. Yeah, that's why I want to create tutorials at night, but for now I need to do it in the morning. That's the problem here. People doesn't know that I am here. Okay. So here I'm going to add some to a little pink. I'm gonna make a little yellowish here. Okay. I'm gonna add some white. I'm gonna create some highlights here. Okay, so I think I am good with the clouds. I will not focus on the clouds here. I will do more on the background, on the houses or whatever. I'll just maybe retouch later on that. Okay, so here I have some blue on yellow and white. So I'm gonna make a blue green. And then we're gonna create some details on this greenish details on this mountain here. So we're gonna make some to look like forests. But I want to create some light blue. I want to create some shadow here. Some bluish tone on the back. This hasn't reached by the sunlight yet. Yeah, next to this wee part here, I'm going to add more yellow and white. You can use a bristle flat brush here. You can use this thing. Create as a forest trees, okay? There. And then I'm gonna use this yellow and white. There. Make sure this is straight, everyone. Okay. So I'm going to put some fields on the back of this house. I'm gonna put more yellowish. I think I want lighter. Maybe later I'm gonna improve that one. I think I'll be using a bigger brush. So yellow with a little red. Okay, I think that looks good. Yeah, I'm sorry everyone if... Okay, I think that looks good. Yeah, I'm gonna put a little more orange colors there. So blue on the raw umber. Yeah, I'm gonna put a little red. So I'm gonna put some this will be the I'm gonna make this palm tree forest, but I think I'm gonna make it a little lighter, not so dark, just raw umber and no, just red and the blue. Yeah. Okay. So these are palm trees here, everyone. I'm gonna put details later. But I'm gonna have some yellow and white. Okay, we're gonna put some holes there. And also here I'm gonna put some holes. Okay. I will be using this but I think I'm gonna make it dark first here. Sorry everyone, the people noisy outside. Hi, really doesn't know how that I'm here. But I'm here working. So here I'm gonna create some shadow first. And I will be using this liner brush. Hopefully everyone, you can hear them in the background. Blue and the red. So this will be the tree trunk. Okay, so I think I'm going to start adding some details now on this trees here. I'm a little excited. Blue and yellow and white. siya. Then just use this number 2 flat brush. It's a smaller brush and it's good for creating details. We'll also put some trees here. I'll be using some yellow. This blue and white. I'm gonna make it more like orange. Yeah, I think I'm going to make it more like bluish and white. You can also use the number 1 liner brush or the round brush because it will be a lot smaller, it will be better. Okay, there, so you cannot see lights on the, so my lights coming from the left side, so everything, every highlights will be on the left. Okay, this is also a tree here. So I'll just use this brush to create highlights on this tree. And put more highlights. There, and then I'll be using the liner brush now, and I'm gonna use a lighter color, mix it with the existing green, and then you can put a little light here. Just put some highlights to create a realistic effect on the trees. Yeah, and then I'll be using the raw umber. and then I'm gonna put some white. Because I'm going to put some tree here. Okay. I'm gonna use this yellow because I'm gonna put some highlights on the tree. I want it to be more yellowish. Yeah, I think that looks great. Okay. Yeah, and then I'm going to put some more orange or yellowish grasses there. I'll put some white. Create some grasses. Okay, yeah, that's good. Okay, so I'm going to proceed here. I'm going to create some river bank. So I'm gonna use this dark color first.
Thank you.
Ayan. Make it dark. And also here. Umber, blue, and then yellow, and then I'm gonna put some white, and then yellow, and put the highlights here. Maybe I'm going to make it lighter and more yellowish. Okay, and now I'm going to start adding details on this native house. So here I have some raw umber. I'll put some yellow there and red. Let's put some shadows first. This is the shadows, everyone. Raw umber and blue to make it dark. Okay. I'm gonna put something here and also here. So I like the design of the house. Okay. And then I will just try to put some highlights first. So I have yellow. I'm gonna put it on the with red to make it a little orange and white. I'll try to use the pure white, everyone. And then also here, I'm gonna put some little highlights. See? The lights here. Then I will try to put more lighter color on the ground, but it will be much more yellowish. Yellow and red. Yeah, I can put it to the ground color or the color of the ground, everyone. Yeah, and then on the roof, everyone, I should put some few details, but I'm gonna put some raw umber and white only. Okay. And add some little shadow here. And of course, I need some window. Yeah. Then I need to darken what is inside the window. So, raw umber and blue, red. I have to put this, I use this raw umber and white, just raw umber and white, everyone. will put some lighter details here. This is back on the house and there's no light here, but it doesn't mean that it should be dark. You can also put a little lighter colors here. Make sure that you use the liner brush so that you can have a smaller details. And now I'll try to use this white. I'll try to put some fewer design or details here. Some railings or something like that. Okay. I want to make it lighter. And also here I need to put some details on the top of the, yeah that looks great. Yeah, I think that looks nice. Yeah, I think I'm gonna extend here, but I'm gonna put more darks or details there. I'll be using this raw umber with a blue color and a little white. I'm gonna put some blue stone. Okay. Yeah. put tinier details like that, and also here. Okay, I think that looks nice, everyone. Okay, so I'm going to continue on the other side. So here I'm gonna put this details on this tree here, big tree in the back of this house, but I will be using another brush. So here, raw umber with blue and red. If you have black, you can also use black, but I don't recommend it. Just use this color. I'm gonna put a big tree here in the bottom. It's gonna be like a mango tree or something. Yeah, it looks like a mango tree. There. Just want to make it dark, really, really dark there, on the bottom, on the shade of this tree. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so I think I'm gonna start putting some details now on this tree. It's a little wet, but I think that will be fine. I'm gonna use this bristle flat brush, yellow and blue. So yellow and blue first. With a little red, but more blue, yellow. We're gonna use first a darker color, and after this we're gonna use a lighter for the highlights. But this one will be on the dark side, that's why it's dark. Okay, and then we're gonna put the lighter colors yellow and blue and white. Yeah, just do it once and it'll be look good. Just one strokes like that. Make sure that your brush is wet or a little wet, not so much. Highlights will be on the left side. Okay, there. Yeah, I think that's good. Now I'm going to put some holes there. But first I think I'm gonna put some branches, umber, red and yellow and white. And then I'm gonna put some holes there. So first I'm gonna use this blue. I'll use this Umber flat brush. Blue, umber and blue. Red and blue, I'm sorry. And then white. Put holes everyone with the hollow part of the tree. Yeah, and then I'm gonna make it a little darker because my back is the mountain, so it will be a little darker. Okay, I think that will be fine. Yeah, that's good. It looks good. Okay, so I'm going to finish this one. It's more than an hour now, and yeah, I'll try to finish it a little more faster. Okay, and I'll put more plants or whatever I'm gonna put here. So I'll be using the bristle flat brush. And then I have here some blue, yellow and red. I'm gonna make it a little darker. Yeah, maybe I'll do it. I'll do first the water reflections. Oh no, so this one I'm gonna put some darks. So I'll just use this one. A little dark greens. Yeah, I should do it earlier. But you can do it earlier if you want. Okay, this one. And I'm gonna do the reflection. And first, I'm going to create some river bank here. Okay. And then blue and red. And white. It's the reflection of the mountain. And then also I need more bluish. Reflection of the distant forest. Okay. So whatever you see on the top, you should put it down for the reflection. Okay, and then I'll be using more red and white. Should be more pink. I'm gonna put the reflection. Also here. Because there will be reflection for the trees here. Yeah, and then of course we're gonna put the reflection of the palm trees or coconut trees. I'll be using this blue color with some red and a little greenish more. Yeah, a little white. Yeah. And yellow to make it a little greenish. can just make a little distortion here on that tip. That's good. Okay. And then I'm going to do now this here using this brush. I'll do first I'm gonna put variety of plants there. I'm gonna do first this light green. Yellowish. Also some big leaves or whatever plants we can find here. Okay, and also here. Here's the topping technique, everyone. I will also put some orange, red, and yellow. Nice. Yeah, I think I'm gonna put a small bridge there. Yeah, it would be perfect if we're gonna put the bridge. Yeah, on the river. Yeah. Yeah, I think we're gonna put the bridge. Okay, so I'll just put the bridge, everyone. It will be a wooden bridge. So I'll be putting first the dark. Okay, I'm gonna put highlights, so yeah, red and yellow. I have more yellow and white. Okay, let's just put the highlights on the top. Okay. And then I will try to put more details. I need to refill some. No, soy yellow. White, yellow, and red. So we have another bridge. I think that looks good. And then we're gonna put also some reflection on the bridge. I'm gonna put more bluish. And then I'm going to put some reflections. Okay. Yeah, I think that looks nice, everyone. Yeah, I'll just retouch everyone and I think I am done. Yeah, here I think I'm gonna put some dress that you put there on the sun. Okay, I'm gonna put some white first. Thank you. maybe they just finish washing, and also put some red. Not just red, but blue. Okay. There. Yeah, I think I'm going to add more. I think I'm going to put some birds or a people there, or yeah. Yeah, well, I will put one people here that he's wearing, he's holding some I think umbrella. Yeah, maybe he's going to somewhere else. I'm gonna use this yellow. Yeah, maybe in the center of the center of the beach. Okay, and then I'm gonna use this yellow and white. Try to use this umber because I cannot figure out the person here. Some reflection. Okay. What else? Yeah, I think I'm going to do retouching now, and I think I'm almost done. Yeah, just to use some bluish color, and I'm gonna put it here. Try also to put another person. Yeah, I'll just use my time, everyone, because it's okay, it's fine. Just something like that. It will not be so clear because it's very, very small. The details is very, very small. Put also some swans there on the river. Okay, then one more highlights and I'm done, everyone. So here I have yellow, and then I'm gonna use some white. Also here. We'll try some orange. Okay, so I think this will be fine, everyone. I think I'm done. Yeah, I just want to retouch a little more. Okay, so I think I am done, everyone. So you can add more details if you want to, but I think for me now that's really good. So far, for small canvas, I'm content with the result and I think I love it. So
okay, everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praise always belongs to the Lord.